Hello, everyone, and welcome back once again to Infra. Last time we uncovered's not the word for it, a huge conspiracy in which we found out the truth about the infamous Metro accident, the thing that's kind of been the specter in the back of everything that's going on in this city. The government actually had all the survivors killed to cover up what seems to be some kind of nuclear weapons development program. But their top scientists, none other than Xander Berg, actually managed to escape, leaving behind this diary, and we are now following in his footsteps. Now, I probably should have left this guy in the drain up there, but, well, I made a promise to allow him to see daylight, and we'll be keeping him with us until that promise is fulfilled. Sorry. But yeah, it's a lot to take in. It really is, but we're more spurred on than ever. We have to make sure that all this information sees the light of day. I'm gonna start using my flashlight more because this is a very dark series, and I'm aware that after render it's even darker, so some things are probably really hard for you to see. So I'm gonna plop you down there.
Can't carry any more of these.
Let's go ahead and replenish these whenever possible. There was a big conversation last night in the Discord about whether or not the battery mechanics are actually appropriate for this game, and I'm kind of two minds on it. Some of you said that, well, you know, it encourages exploration. You know, it encourages you to poke around in all the little drawers and such, which is true. But also, like, you know, you don't want to not have your flashlight ever. And what good does it do for you to be able to find secrets but not collect them because your camera doesn't work? It's not intrusive. It doesn't ruin the game at all. I've never or rarely had an issue where I didn't have batteries when I wanted to do something. But then it's just a question of, well, why is it even there? Door that's actually opened. Cool. So the way we're going to keep you from being too intrusive is we're going to leave you just kind of around and come back to get you when we're done. Good free stuff. Good stuff. Very good. Nice. Jim. Is this the take one, leave one library for the homeless?
I have like a ton of these things already.
How are we doing on you? Still good. Howdy. As you came into view, you actually caught me off guard a little bit. And it's not the first time one of you has done so. Keep out. Why? Wow, it is very dark through here. Oh, is that a metro train running overhead? We must be just parallel to a track, and this looks to be a main sewer pipe. More damage. And we explore the— oh my god! I got close to this to try it, and I just saw— like, I didn't even have the light out, I just saw, like, your silhouette on the edge of the ambient light. I was looking at the handle, and then I just looked up and saw a humanoid figure. There's that breathy sound again. That kind that could very easily just be the pipes, but I don't know. It sounds a little more organic. Wow. Somebody's just blocking off all the different avenues of this place, but why? I guess it's sort of like Tunnel B2, in that even without being explicitly told, you walk through here and you just get the impression that amongst those who live down here, they tell stories about this place. Wow, this place is in real rough shape. Just trying to cover everything. Yep, that— pretty much every catwalk down here is completely collapsed. And at this rate, I'm gonna have to go back for those batteries. So getting down there, there's a ladder right there we can use. Actually, I've just realized something. I mean, look at that. from a distance in these tunnels, you can actually see, like, the moisture in the air catching in your flashlight. That is such a cool detail. Guys, remember, this is Source. Actually skip the ladder and jump down like that. Although we clearly wouldn't want to. We can climb all the way down here. But let's take this one thing at a time. Flush line valve, keep closed. However, it is clearly not closed. So we need to either find another wheel or maybe this will be enough. Yeah, no, that's not enough. pH sensor. I wonder if the low pH warning light would be on if we hadn't fixed that thing earlier. Because we learned that that whole bunker doesn't actually happen, a whole segment of the game that does not occur if we don't fix the dam. Well, fix is a strong word. We didn't fix anything. District supply line valve. Do we want to close that? Do not close if both flushing lines are open. Actually, just keep this always open. And district supply line valve, we can open that. We probably want to close the other things, right? Bergman. Just imagine that. He escaped through his own projects. He really is a mole man of his own making. That valve wheel over there is probably what we're looking for. So let's grab you. Be very, very careful not to lose it down into the water below. I wonder what happens if that happens. And now we should be able to close this.
That should do it.
There we go. And now I'm going to save and see what happens if we mess with the thing that it said to keep always open. So you guys are working. What happens if we do this? Nothing that I can see. Okay, we'll just leave you the way you were. I imagine, yep, that means we'll be able to access you now. Get on open. And we'll probably shut it behind us in case more shenanigans ensue. Wait, what's over here? Purple valve, which means there's probably going to be others in different colors. You're closed off. You're locked, but we can climb in through the window, presumably. Yes, we can. You're broken. And a fuse. Okay, we're gonna have to deal with a puzzle here.
A sledgehammer. Might come in handy, I guess.
You can carry that around, but you won't carry bolt cutters? Let's see what's back here. Another valve. Ooh, and some batteries up there. Yep.
I don't think I can fit these in my pockets.
Alright, what are we doing here? Because I can go back here, and I can turn this on. That will not hurt us. There's another one up there in the shadows. Maybe these all have to be turned. Now you're doing that. Well, I don't know why we'd want that. And you just break right off. Well, I imagine you'll be useful in the future then. Still locked. So now we've got a red and a purple valve wheel and a fuse. Now what is the... Oh my god. I know where we are, guys. I know where we are. First of all, let's use the sledgehammer to knock this down. Yeah, we're gonna be here a while. Come on. Oh, I guess we're just going through here. Yep, it's the homebrew coffee machine. This is the kind of thing smart, bored people get up to. Mulex Copan, the perfect coffee maker. Missing yellow, red, blue, pink. And remember that these are the results. Bobby is our mascot. And here's the list of recipes. Oh, this really can do it all. Alright, let's get the stuff. There's another fuse right there. Bear in mind that though I do remember this puzzle, I do not remember how to do it. So that will still very much be something that I have to solve. There's actually a lot of different outcomes to this thing, and I'm going to try to get them all. So we should be able to attach you somewhere, and you. Okay, and that's all the valves present. You go there. You go there. Now this machine is working. And we've just got to figure out how we actually do this. Button there, four wheels. So right now we've got three options. We've got coffee, something, and coffee plus FD, whatever FD means. But how do we actually operate this boy? So each of these is a switch. Oh wait, there's a bunch of these things. So let's, your milk, and there's gotta be a red one somewhere, right? Special? Or maybe we have to create that? The store down here is locked and not gonna open. As far as I can tell, we have no way of changing it. Yeah, I'm just looking around for this mysterious red can. What happens if we do whatever this is? And we get, this is like a mix and matcher, right? And close that. And there's just so much here. And now we can do that. I have no idea what I'm doing. Oh. We broke it. All right, let's do the emergency stop then. Do we get our stuff back? We do. It never actually made the things. Although you got thrown about. So we probably gotta look at that as well. God, what could this be doing that results in such catastrophic failure? Okay, so the coffee always goes in hatch one, and then we can put whatever in the others. So if we do coffee plus milk this way, now we've got green, so that will result in something. No, it won't. Even though it was flashing green, it still didn't work? Wait, turning these things has results. How do we... Okay, we can... I'm starting to work this out. There we go. And now we do this. And that should work. You really just have to puzzle out all the lights and what it wants you to do. Should be nice.
Hey, lead them, pick me up.
Delicious. But we're not done yet. Also, I'm not sure if you can actually win Bobby. Like, I don't know if this glass thing actually opens. I've just always assumed that there was some way to do it. But we've already got enough passengers. Let's try it with mushrooms now. But you do not like that. So we want you. We want you. We do not want you, and we do not want you. Okay, this is actually much simpler than I had always thought. I don't actually remember being so confused by this thing. I probably looked up a guide back in the day. All right, there's our mushroom tea.
Not bad.
Are we now getting a look at those hallucinogenic properties? Mushroom Bear, we're gonna be in big business. Or big trouble, depending on how things go. How long is this gonna last? Answer, not very long, but it was fun while it did. Ooh. That door is just open now. But you guys probably already know, some of you do, and I definitely know there is something more we can do here. Oh, there you are. Okay, so you do exist. You're not something that we have to, like, produce out of the combinations. I was thinking so much about, like, the different combinations, and I ran into the same issue that I always run into, which is the puzzle is actually much less complicated than it at first appears. Alright, and I believe there's also an achievement we can get here, so let's drop you, put you in. I think this'll do it, if we can only get these valves right. There we go. And you. I love how the whole building shakes as a result of this coffee machine. What an ominously slow reveal. Remember, they just call this special. There it is. And the weird thing about all of this, like, the weirdest thing to me, is that it's inexplicable. I don't know if this is supposed to have done something, because when I first played this, I was just screwing around and just happened to get that result. And not only was I scared by just how caught off guard I was, of not being able to make out what it was, but knowing that something was there, being able to see that its movement was so weirdly smooth, but just inexplicably, this door was now open. We didn't do anything physical to earn this reward, it's just we went through that experience and now there it was.
I'm pretty sure that's not meant to be like that.
Okay, well, we're gonna go get Mr. Bear. But before we do that, there is actually an achievement for drinking 3 cups of the special coffee. Oh, I'm dead. Long day ahead. Drink a lot of coffee. And it starts us off right back here. Well, I guess I won't do that this time. Alright, you're with me. Let's open you up. Send you on your merry way. Actually, wait, have I screwed things up for myself? I might have. And redo all this. That's certainly not good. Wind, if you could slow down for just a second. Good lordy geez. Oh, and we can't even really walk along the side because those pillars are in the way. Oh, look, it's an open sewer private island. That is so funny. Get all the damage we can. Yep, this does function as a ladder. Wow, this is actually really nice. It's big, it's spacious, it's well lit, and it's not super moldy. I might consider buying myself an island down here. Although I suppose if I pay for it, I'm already missing the point. Flood door. Wait. Oh no. Oh no. That's probably not good.
That doesn't sound good. I should get out of here, and fast.
Yeah. Okay, there's an extra valve wheel here, meaning this one's probably gonna break off. No? Wait, maybe I need it for the other one? Maybe for the other door. And let's send that over there. Let's send- oh no, the bear! Right. There, No? What do you mean, no? What am I doing then? Place you here? Should I be saving? Is now the worst possible time to save? What do I do? Can I- Oh no, it goes right here, it goes right here! Okay, okay, well, we know what to do now. I don't know how much time we have. Go. Go! The urgency of the soundtrack is our sign.
Shit, go. It's stuck.
Okay, probably physics, right? I was making a note of the hole here. Well, there we go. Oh, there's... I had thrown a brick down earlier. I think we're out of time. Come on now. Go. It's not enough. We're dead. Oh well. Yeah. At least we got to see it. Man, I would have succeeded at that if I hadn't spent so much time trying to figure out why this door wasn't working.
That doesn't sound good.
That's a really annoying red herring to show us first. Right, let's just... Oh my god, get up there. Let's put as many of these things as we can up there, because I don't know how many we're going to need. Yep. Seriously? You're the one that decides to have some bounce. Right, so you're gonna go here. We're gonna try to do this.
Shit, it's
stuck. Have to weigh you down, which you guys don't neatly fit in there a lot of the time. Like if we're holding you at an angle. There we go. And there we go. Oh, not enough. Not enough. And there we go. Meaning you are now open, meaning we can now escape with time to spare. Or at least that's the hope. God, way to get across a sense of urgency with soundtrack that actually sounds... Well, actually, it sounds like both music in tune or in time with this, while simultaneously being actually... is the word diegetic? When it's actually part of the world and not just in the soundtrack. Well, I guess we made it. And judging by the sound of things, that also causes it to not happen, thus confirming my suspicion that this is all an attempt to kill us. Actually, that's something that I've been thinking about between the last episode and this one. Look, we found dynamite. We found unexploded dynamite under the main metro station. I actually do believe that this isn't coincidence, that somebody sees that I'm doing this and may actually be trying to eliminate me or at least slow my roll. Nothing here. More
that makes 10 packs
batteries,
of batteries
here. Can I really not take these walkie-talkies? Even if they're only for myself. Choo-choo mini trains. I just love mini trains. I need to find more mini trains and make them go around the tunnels. Who doesn't love trains? That's kind of the attitude I've been taking, so I'm really glad you're here. Something that I love about this game's sense of humor is that it's very self-referential. Like, you go through the same things for so long that you eventually, like, seeing the same things starts to become a joke in and of itself. Let's sit you right on the hood there. Oh no, this isn't going anywhere. Is there one further? Oh, we can reverse it. Alright, so let's sit you right on the hood there. Come on. There we go. Oh no, 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 no. Okay. We're gonna need to place you down here, and hopefully that'll work. No. Huh, I could swear I've used you before this way. Okay, well, tell you what, you just wait here and I'll go ahead and see what's up, and if I'm not able to come back, well, this place looks like it's actually staffed, so somebody will come for you at some point. Yep. You know, maybe not the best idea to go this way while that's still the case. So let's get you. And now we can continue. This feels so wrong. It's functionally identical, but it feels so wrong. You'll come as far as here, and then you'll be on the right track.
Well, time to turn around and find another way.
Yeah, yeah. I do actually find the mini train motors to be really annoying, so let's do that. Now, what have we here? Possibly damaged. So let's turn you off and turn you guys on. Flip you. And there you go. And that should help us, right? Nevertheless, we're going to save. You know, I just started thinking, like, what if... No, we need to switch you, but we can't switch you. Going all the way back doesn't seem to work. There's no switches anywhere. I guess we're walking it. But yeah, I just got this idea that... What if the worker who loves these mini trains and, you know, operates this station... What if he, like, had a bear that he, like, lost down a sewer grate one day, and now this thing just turns up wet and covered in mushrooms, and he thinks he's being haunted? No. I really don't like how long this tunnel is. We can step through here. Question is, do we want to? I'm just really anticipating the moment when something's gonna come barreling down these tracks. Yep! I knew it, and it's... unoccupied, too. That's strange. Can't get through there, but there is a switch on that side. And we can't open that either. So, yeah, we need to get it over here so that this can open. Alright, I think we have to go up this other way. I think we might have saved ourselves by stepping onto this track early, but not following through. Yep, I can see these spaces off to the side where we could have decided to hide from that thing. I just hope there won't be another one. God, it is so long and so dark. Actually, I think I do have vague memories of spending a lot of time running up and down here. I may have even been hit by the train. Yep, there you go. You'll come through periodically. But yeah, we do get through here, all right. So we can now do a U. And we can't open you from this side. Maintenance access, OF01. But that's locked too. Exit. Of course. And I suppose I'll just wait here for the next train to come, because I don't want you to show up at an inopportune time. Sewer pipe 3, you're missing a valve wheel. Ooh, a key. There we go! Alright. That makes things so much easier. And now we can open you. We actually couldn't bring the train over here. Or at least not yet. There's a little nook up here. Come on, there's gotta be something in the box. I see beer! And a bear! These alcoholic bears, it's a real problem in this city.
I still have nine.
Whenever you find a teddy bear, a bottle of Osmolud is never far behind, although I suppose you could say that about just about anything or anyone here. Even...
This will take more than just a new coat of paint.
Oh, look at this. West Stolberg runoff discharge system. And that tunnel appears to be blocked. Yet the water just doesn't move. ladder going down. And that gate won't open even if we do bring something forward. Oh, what is all this? I feel like I'm missing puzzles so I can go past them and get to puzzles. These gates should probably be open, no? Oh my god. Oh, I'm dreading even having to start digging into this. Oh wow, I didn't expect that door to actually open. A dusty, dirty old maintenance area. Oh, and this actually takes us out right here. Okay, so I really like that about this game, how it has puzzles that are somewhat large and complex, but it at least manages to cut down on the backtracking and walking wherever it can. Oh, that leak is probably not intended. Yeah, wow, that's coming straight down through the concrete.
That's a leak, all right.
Yeah, so I guess that is fine. Oh, wait. I think I actually know where we are. I remember this. Okay, this is an Easter egg that I found while recording another video. It might have been the video game Easter eggs video. I don't think it was even the Infra Easter eggs video, because I don't think I knew about this at the time. But look, if we maneuver our way along these beams, you've got these bars here we cannot get through. Or can we? Crouching through here actually allows us to get into this area. And through here, we actually can climb. I love the really out-of-the-way stuff like this. This is the stuff that's really rewarding to find. Yeah, but even with the flashlight, there's so much moisture in the air, it practically obscures my vision. There's just a haze in front of me. Nothing down here, although I certainly get the impression that something's staring back. You hear that? There it is. Some kind of something making groaning vocalizations surrounded by blue mushrooms and something else. And to make matters worse, like, you know, with Morco there's like lore, but with this, the achievement is just called UGU, U-G-U, all capitals, and the description is simply, find this thing. I feel like the less that's said about this thing, the more bizarre it is, and I guess that's why the devs opted to say very little about it. Well, back to your regularly scheduled infrastructure fixing. Okay, so I'm guessing this is going to be a game of making sure the path is complete. So one button equals two gates. Gates 1 to 3 and button 2 are broken, so we need to reach gate 4. So we need button 1 to gate 4. So let's see how this works. We also need to figure out, well, I guess the switch decides whether it goes through blue or red. Okay, so if we follow this from here, blue would lead to this thing, red out to this thing, red out to this thing, red out would go to here. We switch you to blue, and then red just goes out to here. No, I think that's gone the wrong way. I think the best way to do this would actually be to work our way backwards from gate 4. Up and over to... Wait, and then blue goes up and over to here. And that attaches you to button 2, which is not working. But I guess it proves that I do at least understand how this works. You know, you would think it would be easy to make this much less complicated than this, but... I mean, I've seen server rooms. Alright, so I did end up just looking up a guide. Actually, I think I do remember being stuck on this for quite a long time. And I'm looking at the solution, and the thing is, it turns out I do understand this. Like, I was trying to get the proper result. It's still just, like, a mess to untangle and make sense of. Wait. Oh, well, I think I've got it reversed, but you get the idea. The solution that I'm looking at, these two boxes on the left, this is a few years old, but these boxes on the left weren't black boxes. In fact, there was no such thing as black boxes. So why is that the case? Actually, in the forum that I saw, there were like, the devs were talking about how there were bugs regarding this thing, so maybe they changed it around? Okay, that should do it. And yep, there we go. Now let's just get ourselves down here. Every video game instinct is telling me that a horde of enemies is going to be running through that door now. And that's just the way it works, isn't it? You open up the big gate, and while the alarm sounds, everything comes running in while you have the high ground and the advantage of planning. There's our ticket out.
Let's hope the rebar holds until the repairs.
Yeah, let's hope. These floodlights actually suggest recent activity. Oh, wait, are you closing? You are. You're only held open temporarily. So what are we dealing with here, then? Well, at least that flood door appears to be openable. And the valve wheel is actually here, so that's new. What is all this? That's hilarious. They gave it a little steering wheel, a flag on the back to stream in the wind. That might have been a sound of grinding metal, but it sounded a bit like a high-pitched vocalization. Stop doing that, sir.
I still have 9 packs of batteries left.
And you'd best use them wisely. That definitely sounds like accursed moans. Can't open that, because why would we be able to? Keep in mind, for the past forever in this game, we've just been trying to get back to the office. Like, really, ever since the first water treatment plant. So all this, the bunker, Walter's office, it's all just been in pursuit of that. We're either the best or the worst at our job, depending on how you look at it. Wait, hold up, me from the future here. I actually found something that all started from a discovery I made in post, and so the events leading up to this have changed a little bit, so I'll just let you see what transpired. Can use that for sewer pipe 3. Okay, that did a thing. Oh, there is a thing right here. Broken sewer pipe 3 might have a small leak. Okay. Hang on, just realized there is some dynamite here. So that's something we're gonna have to make a note of. Yep, you close. I just kind of preset that with the right answer. Let's see how that works. Ah, now we've got you going forward. And now we should be able to see just what's going on behind this door. Boop. Oh, there is more. Alright, you're gonna move. Thank you. And then we can change the switch here. Come on, give me that button. Oh, this is a very different type of tunnel. One which it seems we can actually maneuver down. There's a broken mini train here, that's sad. What happens if we crawl all the way to the end? Oh, this is completely collapsed as well. Yeah, no one asked you to. It was a lot of work to get here. A flip of that. That may not work out at first. We may have to back it up. Nope, we're good. And what happens over here? Wait, is that actually an alternate way out? Because if so, that's kind of nuts. Oh, and this opens as well. Okay, wait, this is a lot of extra... Oh, no, 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 no. We saw this already. Yeah, no, oh, I didn't even see this before. Oh, hang on, it's a good thing we came back here. But there's no key. Is it in here? How did you manage to lock your beer in there? Oh, that's a broken pipe. I just happened to notice that because I was coming back. Alright, so what we discovered is that this door will not open for the mini train. We'll move on normally through the vents, but I don't know where the keys are to open that hatch, and I don't want to move on until I do find it. Oh, okay, yep. I figured it would have something to do with under these stairs. Alright, it was actually under the can, I think. So that's actually the first time we've seen something like that. You've got to be kidding me! I can't believe I almost ended the episode without doing this!
Interesting. That makes right. 10 packs of camera
Probably what I'm going to end up doing is... All this started with my curiosity of being, like, in editing. Oh wait, I missed that valve under the stairs. What potential stuff could this unlock? Well, here we are in yet another comfy cozy hideout. The Mushroom Co. The Mushroom Co. fella is still doing that science thing. But I think there's something better than these green slimy glowing mushrooms. Some guy found blue ones. Heck yeah, blue slimy glowing shrooms. Maybe there are yellow and pink ones too. The guy didn't remember where we found the blue ones, but... Wait, dang, these must be some magic shrooms. I had a... something. I had a flu, but when I took a sniff at a blue shroom, the flu was gone. Good stuff. And they aren't even toxic. So I suppose a somewhat safer alternative to the green ones? Why did I check? What does this do? Oh god. Nope. Close it before I die. Thank you. Oh no, I'm still dying.
I still have 9 packs of batteries left.
Alright, I'm gonna send you back to the present now, because I'm gonna do everything exactly the way I did. Mm. But, you know, I feel like it does actually work for this type of game, doesn't it? Because when you have this, like, Half-Life style, where it's all one continuous path of travel, well, it helps convey the themes, how everything is so interconnected. You start pulling one thread, and eventually you're bound to pull the entire thing. Oh wow, there is a lot going on here. What can we see through here? Wow, this is a huge underground construction project. That flooding is probably not supposed to be that way. Yeah, I think it's a little late for that, Mark. I almost said mock. Get through here, but I don't see anything to do with this. Ooh. Well, we can get out this way. There's still so much more to see. Oh, look at this.
Looks ready to collapse.
And we're missing a wheel here, which might be our way out. But what about this? It's always so weird to me when I see, like, the natural caves off to the sides. But this, too, is not holding up so well. Okay, there's gotta be a reason for us to wade down into the water, right? This is so cramped, I can feel it myself. What if we climb back here? Can we do that? No, it doesn't seem so. In a situation like this, I'm always really worried about getting stuck.
Rubber boots, I'm not touching that.
Yeah, this keypad has been smashed. That doesn't look like natural wear and tear. Actually, it looks very deliberate. Maybe if we climb up here, we can see something? I mean, yeah, this is definitely the kind of game that would reward such adventures. Let's see what's down here. This is making me anxious that any moment those gates are gonna open and a torrent of water is gonna come flooding in. Oh no, we've actually made it to the construction site itself. Look at all this. How long has it been left like this? Is this like a whole construction project that was just left abandoned? Look at that damage just hiding all the way up there. Yeah, this isn't under construction. This is, I think, abandoned construction. So, taking all bets, who was working on this? Sander Berg? Jeff Walter? One of Alex Hartman's subversion attempts. There's a generator right here, which we can activate. But we'll save that for later. Yeah, there's an elevator. I'm more concerned about whose car this is. I mean, this looks like something from, like, the 60s, 70s? Looks like it probably belonged to somebody important, some executive who was checking out the project. Did they get here and then never leave?
That's 9 packs of flashlight batteries. Intriguing.
Some of you said that, yeah, a lot of rooms with documents have a light switch. Can't open these drawers. Cistern report A45. The Stolberg Bank is still clearly lobbying against this building project. Now most of the project is on ice until the question of funding is resolved. We tried to tell them how close we are to finishing this project, but they still think the cistern is a very high security problem to the bank. They don't seem to understand it's a much bigger issue if this place is abandoned. The Bergman Group needs money to finish the work, but they froze the bank account and stopped giving us loans. We heard about that earlier. The Stolberg Bank has received the support of a number of influential people required to pull this project down. We either have to stop work or start looking for outside investment. Rebuilding elsewhere would be costly, and the Bergman Group doesn't have much money left. So this is one of those side effects of the shutdown. Aw, it's another one of you, hard at work. One of those little dolls. Can't open you. Actually, I've just realized this window is broken. Somebody smashed their way into here. I'm wondering if this wasn't, like, the site of some kidnapping. That's my main theory right now. Question is, what are the pros and cons? Well, maybe it can only be operated from inside. Hearing those metallic echoes all throughout the place. Why are these floodlights on right here, right now? That's my question. We stack enough boxes, we could get up there. Yeah, boop. And you were gonna go here. Nope, don't fall over. And we can't climb you because there's only two, but we can sure jump down. Yep. The actual platforming sort of segments are rare in this, but they are present. I'm not gonna try it, but it may be possible to subvert this whole up and over puzzle by jumping onto the top of that truck and then going over the wall. Oops! Well, I always expected it to happen sooner or later. Actually, I guess the last time that happened was early on in the Bergman tunnels, wasn't it? Actually, in very similar circumstances, in all these scaffoldings and catwalks. And there's our fast travel up and down. But it doesn't seem to actually be working at this moment. There's actually nowhere we can go from here, so I guess we do need it? That's probably our objective over there, that door on the left. That's a time for a save. Oh, there's a switch on the side. There we are. And now we can do what we need. So what do we want to do? Let's try... Can we go up? No, there's no more up. But there is an auto down that isn't working. Oh, manual is toggled on. Well, maybe that's actually better. Because then we can get off wherever we need. I'm gonna do auto down. Can we not do that because we're not at a regular position? Okay, I was gonna say we can do auto down and then just do a pass to see where we need to be. I'm legitimately just not sure where we can go. Well, we can climb. Ooh. We can climb on top of this thing. Do not step on. Well, that sign can't stop me because I can't read. I've got several useful mantras to recite in this series. Here's what I'm thinking. We toggle manual. I don't know what that just did right there. And if we auto up, how quickly will you start to move? Very quickly, actually. Very, very quickly. Can we, faster than we can climb. Come on now. Yep. Yep. Or perhaps faster than we can climb. Maybe not. Maybe we can still make it. Oh, we can't exit here. Let's go. Oh, we're not going to have time for this. We're not going to have time for this. I'm so glad I got that on the first try, because I could see this being something that I get stuck on for a long time. Not because I can't figure it out, but because every time you screw this up, you gotta reset the whole thing. Thanks for the advice. That is so funny. I probably wouldn't have thought to do that right away if it hadn't explicitly told me not to. But let's save our game and look around. Because even though the path out is clear, I'm still quite worried there could be infrastructural damage here. I mean, besides what I already know is here. You know, I will say, for the purposes of Let's Play, I have definitely landed on not liking the use of flashlight batteries, or at least having them be this bad, for the simple reason that I have to keep turning it on and turning it off. It's really irritating, and probably even more irritating to watch. What do these buttons do? Emergency outflow broken. What about the other one? Oh wait, is that gonna open like another door or something? Yeah, you're opening down there. You might not stay open, but at least we know what to do. You can make our lives so much easier, but of course you're not going to. This seems worth reporting on, to me personally.
I still have 9 packs of batteries left.
And of course we can't open this. Now what is over here in VOD 4? Well, some
that
flashlight
makes 10
batteries.
Packs of batteries for the flashlight.
And some chemicals that probably shouldn't be stored here, but other than that, that's about it. That door I can see is closed again, but we're gonna end up climbing back up here because I don't want to be rushed when I try and see what we can report downstairs. I gotta wonder, if this was never even completed, how many people even know this is here? This huge underground cavern, which never got to fulfill its purpose, and which a whole section of city could end up falling into at some stage. That could have been bad. You can't lower that ladder at all. Oh, well, actually, I suppose... Yeah, I could jump down to here. It hurts, but I can do it. And now here we are. No quick way up. I hate how quickly we go through these batteries. You're really not going to report this. Well, I guess it's not even collapsed. It's just not in yet. Actually, this one is, so maybe they'll be nice and this one can be too. Oh, God, imagine trying to ascend these steps after everything we've been through today. Actually, even worse, imagine trying to walk back down. But it is going to be nice. And it's going to make it so much easier when we decide to run down there after these gates open. I feel like I'm having, like, immense luck with some of the puzzles today. Like, these are all things that I sort of have vague memories of being stuck on for a long time. And they're just breezing by. I would not be able to rocket down these steps like this. Mark is some kind of infrastructure terminator. Which is the kind of praise you'd, like, cringe at in an office setting, but here it's actually kind of apt. Okay, there's something crazy going on in here that I don't have time to unpack. I'm hearing birds! We're close to the surface. Okay, well, I guess we can't do anything with you. And you're gonna close this in. Look at this. This is such a beautiful game, you guys. All flooded in the center. Anything of use down here? No? But we can climb out. Look, we've even got, like, little effects of the flies buzzing in the stagnant water. This doesn't count as damage, or maybe that's what I got before? Oh no, it's definitely gonna have us walking along these pipes. I can already see the path. But at least we're finally close to the surface, right? I mean, this is just, we're like Batman in The Dark Knight Rises, where you have to rise, like some kind of Dark Knight.
Let's hope the rebar holds until the repairs.
Don't count on it. Let's make our way through here. Trying to flashlight as much as possible so that you guys can actually see. Yep. This has definitely been... Last episode was a very conspiracy-heavy part. This episode is a very platform-heavy part. I don't like that. Don't like that. Don't like that. Remember to close that door! I guess all's well that ends well.
This will take more than just a new coat of paint.
Mark, I aspire to have your attitude about things one day. Nothing in this office. And that door even locked itself. See, for our safety. Yep. Now, what's going on in here? Well, I guess all this isn't supposed to be here. Oh, no, it's not the drums, it's the dynamite. How could I have forgotten? So what is this? Liquid gypsum. We've actually been seeing tanks of that stuff all over the place. I don't know if it's a reused asset or if there actually is something to that. You're broken. And we've got some stackable boxes, which will no doubt be useful in the near future. What if we stack those stackables over here? I just wanted to see if there was maybe something hidden under or behind them. Okay, so now what? I was actually just trying to get over to a ladder that would have allowed me to go up the wall, but now... Oh, well, there's our answer. There's where we're going. Oop. Thank you for letting me climb up through the... whatever you call them? What would you call these? They're not ropes, because they're flat. Straps? Strap seems inappropriate for the industrial use. In any case, look at this. The whole roof of this thing, with all the soil that's been washed down here, it's become a natural flower bed. Or an unnatural flower bed, I suppose. But I think we need another box. Nope, no! Oh, well, it's a good thing we've got spares. I even heard the splash down below. I don't know to what extent I actually want to stand on this thing. Come on. That was real precarious. Don't you go getting more precarious on me. There we are. And we should be good now. Yep. I did not trust that dip to keep me upright. Nothing here. And here we are. Well, we made it.
Still 8 packs of batteries left.
Who, asbestos?
Didn't they ban this stuff?
There's still plenty around, Mark. can't open that, of course, because nothing can ever be easy. That looks like it's in rough shape. That's a chainsaw, which seems weird for this setting. And that's a grill with some fresh sausages left out, too. Wow, people really will live anywhere.
That's 9 packs of flashlight batteries.
You know, this is basically Life Finds a Way the game, isn't it? Now, there's a whole lot of different elements we can look at. That's not gonna work. We can climb up over there and find another one of those little plushies. Or wait, does a plushie have to be fuzzy? Or can it just be one of those little rubber squeezables? In any case, we can climb on top of that crate using those boxes. But what happens if we go back a little bit more? Yeah, I want to get into that control room. Ooh, and to my surprise, the door actually opens. Nothing back here that I can see. But of course, in the absence of any actual function, this place ceases to, well, function.
That makes 10 packs of batteries for the flashlight.
But we've got a key. Oh wait, the key probably goes to that door with the stairwell. There we are! Oh, let's see where this takes us. We can go up or down. Guess we can solve that problem before we get to it, because I can hear the sound of that steam escaping. They say that sound brings blessings from Gabe Newell. But I don't see where it was. Well, we got over to, I think... Oh no, this isn't where I was originally planning to go. Can't open this. Can get a somewhat clearer view. No. And there we are, but... You know... Well, there is always that thing over there. Do this nice and neat, so we can place you two in the corner right there. You will be placed a little further back. Come on now. Come on, we're so close to doing this neat. Drop. Nope, drop. And now we can climb that. That's not quite enough. I think we're still gonna need at least one more. Oh, I didn't even notice that note over there.
Interesting.
I would have been so annoyed if I hadn't seen that and only caught it in editing. This is it. I'm ending my life. Everyone who knows me can understand why I'm doing this. This job was everything I had left, and I don't even have that. Jeff Walter bought the Bergman Group, and he didn't even try to save it. If there's someone to blame, it's definitely him. But everything else is my fault. I lost my family and many of my good friends. I can't blame Osmo Alute. I was drinking to make me feel better and trying to forget everything. I'm sorry. Did you maybe jump from here? Oh.
Fascinating.
Well, if we're finding this empty, though, maybe you never went through with it? I mean, we haven't found a body, and for all this to still be here... I actually wonder if that's not maybe Eric Kleinman writing that note. And we kind of haven't heard from him in quite a while. Oh, we can definitely walk out over all that. We can start this piece of machinery. We can climb up here, but I doubt it'll do much for us. Yep. Oh, this does actually open. Oh, we can move on! I'm not moving on. I've still got stuff to do here. There's still so much to look at.
I still have 9 packs of batteries left.
Yeah, see? Down here, we get to the other side. But it's locked. It was always locked. This was always a ruse. Down. Yep. Going backwards from the obvious solution has usually yielded fruit. Now we can get down on top of this little hatch. Come on, there's gotta be something down here. Somewhere we can drop down. That is so weird. Is there really no reason for this? Alright, let's see what you've got for us. You're not doing anything. Well, I can't seem to find anything else, so I guess I'm out. Now these look like pumps, but they're not actually running. Well, that's not good.
I'm sticking a fork in the mountain. No thanks.
Yeah, and you'd know, wouldn't you? You seem like the type who might have tried it as a kid just to see what would happen. We can go out that way. Anything further? We can go down. Mm-hmm. Wow, huh? There's actually a lot to this. Oh no, this just opens up on this side. Okay, well that makes things a little bit easier. That puddle of water on the ground isn't comforting, given the circumstances. What is this? Door here that does actually open. Oh, look at all this, but it's totally dry. Unlike the staff. Where does this all go? This connects to where I just was, and that's blocked off. Wait, so, alright, so our next thing is gonna be how do we get down there? Ladder. Yeah, this not only looks dry, it looks like it's been dry for quite a long time. Is there a reason for that? Like, that's the thing. I don't know enough about infrastructure to know if it's supposed to be like that. I know you aren't supposed to be there, but I also understand I have my mission and you have yours. So I'm not gonna say anything about it. There's a ladder.
Still 8 packs of batteries left.
First time we've hit 8 in a while, I think. You know, they're really adamant about keeping us out of certain sections of tunnel in particular. Typically down long, dim hallways where, I guess, whatever problem couldn't be dealt with and they just decided whatever's there can have it. Let me guess, locked? That's what I thought. You know, there is an inordinate amount of barricaded off areas in active infrastructure, like places where people work today. But something this game is starting to make me realize is that infrastructure is so vast. Like, there's probably not, like, the guy who mans this room, right? Like, there might be some places like that, but I imagine a lot of stuff is likely just another checkmark on somebody's list, right? Like, there's probably a schedule where maybe somebody pops into most places, like, every couple of weeks, every couple of months. There we are. Seems a cozy spot. Although I would very much hate being sat above this all the time. And it would remind me of the pit from Army of Darkness. We're not gonna photograph that. I guess it's only when something is to the point of unusability that Mark considers something to be broken. Did I hallucinate a fuse on the ground? Was it just me looking at that pack of cigarettes? That is so weird. I could have sworn I saw one, like, clear as day. Oh no, there it is. Climb up on the seat and grab you. What we actually use you for is still anyone's guess. Actually, these things don't always have a use. I mean, we found a ton of them that we didn't need. Or at least that I think we didn't need. Makes me kind of feel like I probably missed stuff. Okay, so that's why we need to power this door so that we can open it up. There we go. That is it exactly. Boop. Now we can open that when we please, but there's still a ladder to climb. Although I hope there's not a ladder to climb in our work, because, as I've said, I do love this job.
That's 9 packs of flashlight batteries.
There we go. And let's say we get out of here. This part's got to be concluding pretty soon, right? I don't think the chapter ended in the last part. Oh, hey, is that coal? This looks like a coal conveyor belt. Are we playing Factorio? Hang on, what's down here? Why would this be running through this? We can definitely climb over there. This is always the dance. You gotta run all the way down one way and all the way down the other way when you meet in the middle. No, but I can hear machinery grinding somewhere behind the walls. A whole bunch of bricks and some camera batteries. Ow! 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 Oh god, oh god, oh god! Why did that happen? I'm stuck, actually. I think I might be stuck. Well, let's reload a save. I don't know why that happened. Oh! I see why now. That's a bomb! Okay. I guess it's being mined up like unexploded ordnance from World War II? Even still, I'm so lucky that didn't kill me. Realistically, it would have and done a lot more damage.
Of camera batteries.
But you would think it would not have survived the process that put this ground coal onto the belt, right? I wonder if I... this is so dumb. Part of me was wondering if I could actually, like, walk across all this and maybe get an achievement for doing a coal fire walk. Okay, we're gonna have to do a real platform now. Let's figure out the best way to do this. I'm just realizing this is a drill. We're actually, this is like a mine, right? Like, it has to be. Alright, there's no real run and jump in this game, so, see, we went over the ledge there. The platforming doesn't really work. That's probably why it's so sparingly used.
That makes 10 packs of batteries for the flashlight.
Okay. Any other damage? I mean, any more than the damage that's about to be here if I don't get back to the office and tell people about the friggin' bomb I found.
I'm pretty sure that's not meant to be like that.
And oddly enough, the bomb is the only one that's not deliberately trying to kill people today. They're locked. Every locked door is a thing I don't have to do. Which makes me very happy, even if it probably makes Mark very sad. We're starting to see brick. And an unlocked gate. Ooh, does this mean... are we above ground now? Of course not. That will probably open.
That makes 10 packs of camera batteries.
I feel like we've turned a corner as far as progress goes. Can't open that, although it is 3D beyond. Should probably make note of that pile of bricks. Yep, this looks like we just emerged into somebody's basement. All kinds of machinery for working on stuff and for poorly working on stuff. A screwdriver on a boot. Locked. Oh, we need a key card. Alright, let's try upstairs then. Robin, fix this. So this is broken. We can't get out this way. We can't report it either. But that is so funny. So Robin works here, I guess, or did. Leave it to this Robin we've been hearing so much about to not only use a screwdriver to repair a boot, but to also use one as a doorstop so that it subverts the need for a key card. Ooh. What are we doing here? Of course, there's a whole stack of beer in here. Irvin?
Hello?
Finally, dude. I've been waiting for you like... Wait, you're not Irvin. Who is this?
Mark. I was just...
Robin, we have a very bad situation here. There have been some power cuts in the city.
Including this power plant?
Well, not really. I was just doing some maintenance work here and
you need my help.
Exactly. Well, you need to start up the second generator.
How am I supposed to do that?
Easy. You just need to close... Oh, wait. No, open the valves and pull the lever.
Oh, God. Wow, look, this place is already falling apart.
Someone should get that fixed.
But yeah, it feels like I'm meeting a celebrity. It's so weird to hear about somebody for the entire game. And then you do meet them, and that is exactly what I expected them to sound like. Alright, well, let's let Robin guide us to fixing this power plant. Oh, wow, it says 10 o'clock. How? That can't be right. That would actually be so funny if even the clock in Robin's workstation is wrong. But let's read some of this. The achievement popped when I took a picture of this for getting 90% of the conspiracy documents in this section. Everything normal? Normal. This is getting boring, man. Still nothing to report. I miss the Bergman tunnels, Irvin. Remind me to tell you about my last job. Maybe it says not everything is in order. Come on, Robin, take this log seriously. Robin broke the generator hall door. Generator 2 could probably use some maintenance. Everything okay, just need to fix a few things. Everything is a mess. Robin broke everything. I almost died there. Some guys came here to fix things. I told them about some communication problems. Some minor issues. Irvin fixed them. Everything okay? Wait, normal? Where are you, Irvin? Did Irvin go missing? Normal day. Irvin, I haven't seen you for a few days. Yesterday was normal, and today was nothing special. Oh, July 22nd, Irvin comes back. Had to fix some things. The something was almost broken. Steam feed, maybe? Robin, please fix that door. Sorry, man. I'll fix it soon. I promise. Robin says, there's a hole in my boat. I need to fix it. Okay, real sense of urgency here. Robin, if I do this for you, can we go for a ride on your boat? Can you stop writing useless stuff here? I don't see you around much. So boring. Normal. I'll do some maintenance work soon. Probably next week if I can get around to it. Now I've been asking this whole time, like, is this Robin a malicious character? Or is he actually as incompetent as people say? I'm starting to lean more towards the latter now that we've heard his voice and now that we've seen this log. Also, it's really cool how there's, like, all these little things that change to just sort of acknowledge what you've done up until this point. Ah, well, we do have the key card now. So that enables us to get out here. And maybe have a look around. I love how it taunts us in this way. Like, the one thing, well, not the one thing, but, you know, the major thing that's broken in this place. And it leads straight to that glowing exit sign. Literally, all I want to do is get back to the office, and now the first real person I encounter is asking me to do something that is far, far outside of my pay grade.
One of the generator valves is missing.
Really?
Valves.
Oh, wait. It should be inside the control room. There are some boxes there. It might be in there.
Okay, we'll try that. I'm glad we're going to be getting some more instruction.
There are just beer bottles here.
Oh, wait. It was underneath the control room. The valve should be there somewhere.
Okay. Yeah, this is shaping up to go really well. Did you say it was behind some boxes? Maybe under the stairs? I'm not seeing any valve wheel, bud. Well, we can open this now. Get some more.
Like,
oh, wow, we're actually full of those again. There it is.
Found it. There's also more beer.
Yeah, great job. Now put the beer, the valve, on the generator.
Well, to be fair, that does sound like me when I try to work out a complex task in real time.
Now, open all the valves so we can activate the second burners.
What about synchronizing?
Speed up the generator to 4,000 RPM and then pull the switch.
Okay.
Or is that 3,000 RPM?
Oh my god. So we needed to open up all these valves. So that's probably not good. I'm gonna save here knowing full well this is probably gonna kill me on contact, right? Yeah. Okay, so that doesn't really work. Although it did do something. Alright, now we can try this. We should be able to reach the kind of numbers we're looking for, right? That brings us up to 2,000. And now the other should be able to get us to a maximum of 5,000-ish, right? What am I doing here, guy? This is, like, the max, is it not? Maybe this needs to be changed a little bit. We can't actually use this one. Let's bring it up to 4,000. Okay, there's 4,000. But you can only go lower. At least as far as I can see, we can't even get you to hit 3,000. Alright, screw it. With all kinds of steam blowing out the back, let's just get this going.
Okay, so now that's the generators are on the grid now.
Now, fully open all the valves and activate the boiler lever.
That should be all of them done, and...
done.
There we go. Now let's wait for this to inevitably go wrong so I can snap a photo.
Mark, you're wearing a hard hat, right?
Yeah, why?
I might have made a tiny mistake.
What did you do?
Yep! And that is the end of Act 2.
Eric! I mean, Mark!
That's an honor.
Are you okay? Mark!
I almost died in here. What the hell did you do?
Shit, I'm sorry, Mark. I messed up. You have to get out of there.
I'm trying.
Well, we are in quite a pickle now, as is the city. But we'll be dealing with this next time. I know, what a cliffhanger, right? And if you like this video, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe for more creepy and comfy content. If you have any ideas for other videos you think I should do, the best place to suggest that will be at the Discord, which I will link in the description. If you want to try this game out for yourself, that link will also be in the description. If you want to support me on Patreon, that link will be in the description. And as always, I will see you in the next one.